الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وزِد وبارِك على نبيِّنا محمدٍ وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، عباد الله، يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ثم أما بعد، my dear respected brothers and sisters, today's khutbah بإذن الله تعالى will continue what we started last week about al-kibr, pride, arrogance in the hearts of people. How to know it first, and how to know the importance of this bad feeling in our Islam, and how to avoid it, how to remove it, wipe it from your heart. It's big struggling for everyone has this bad feeling to leave it. It's not easy, my brothers and sisters. It's not easy to leave this bad feeling. Because of that, we should talk about this matter. We should talk about this bad feeling and bad issue in our Islam. We should explain it. We should take care of it. And we should right away try to leave it and wipe it from our hearts. I started with you last week about the types of al-kibr. And I said there are three types: kibrun ma Allah, arrogance but with Allah, wal iyadu billah. Like all these people, those who came before us, they had a big arrogance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the messengers and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conveyed to them the messages, they denied it and they had a kibr with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Fir'aun and his zabaniyah. And also nowadays, al-fara'een al-sighar, the little fara'een, they are existing in every time, in anywhere. Then the second type of al-kibr, it was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam themselves. How they were abusing them, how they were mocking them, having fun on them. Alayhim as-salatu was-salam, wa la'an Allahu al-akhareen. And today, we'll talk about the most important type of these types, which is al-kibr ma'a an-nas, to have pride and arrogance with people. Wal-iyadu billah. Let me in the beginning define this bad feeling. Al-Islam is talking about feelings? Yes, my brothers and sisters. This is the greatness of al-Islam, the greatness of our deen, that the deen itself is teaching us how to feel. Now also how to believe. Now just how to pray, or how to fast, or how to behave. No, ya Habib, how to feel. Al-Islam al-Azim, Allahu Akbar. The definition of al-kibr, of pride, is it has a two parts actually. The first part, feelings in the hearts of people. Feelings tells you that you are better than others. This is the first part of the definition of al-kibr. If you have this feeling, wake up. I'm advising myself first and everyone to check the heart. Check your heart, ya Habib. If you have this matter, if you have this feeling, you have to stop yourself. If you just feel that you are better than others without anything, just it's feeling in your heart, you are better than others. This is the first part of the definition of al-kibr. And the second part, to behave with this bad feeling, bad stuffs. Hypocrisy, lying, to make tricks with others, to abuse others, to accuse others, to have a violence with others. Like what I said last khutbah, 5 characteristics. Please memorize it with me. The first thing, and the second, and the third, it comes with the first part, which is feeling. And the fourth and the fifth, it comes with the second part, which is actions. To love to dominate without haqq. You love just to dominate. And it's not your right, but you love it. First characteristic, domination with al-batil, with falsehood. The second issue, to believe in your rights and you to do not believe in others' rights. Every single thing come in your side, you love it. If it comes for the side of others, you hate it. Second, bad feeling. The third thing, to believe in nonsense. If anything comes to your side, if it sins, you believe in it. If it comes against you, if it sins, you don't believe in it. And generally, you believe in nonsense to have this ego and to continue this feeling in your heart. You don't care about sins. You don't care about the rights of others. And you do care to dominate and control without haqq. 3 bad feelings coming from the notion of you feel that you're better than others. Like what الشيطان إبليس عليه لعنة الله did. The second part actually is the actions. To act, to behave with these feelings in your heart, right away you're gonna accuse others. You're gonna abuse others. You're gonna harass others. Have istifzaz with others. Allahu Akbar. Yeah, you're gonna invoke others. Harassing them, invoking them until you have what you like. That's it. Shaitan wastafziz. We're coming to a shaitan now. We're coming to Iblis to have a connection, to know how this bad feeling comes to the hearts of people, the hearts of mankind. What is the source of it? Then the fifth thing, that if you fail to accuse, you're gonna start and use violence. 5 bad characteristics. 3, it's just feeling. And 2, it's action. From where these 5 bad characteristics came? What is the root of it? What is the source of it? The source of it is الشيطان إبليس عليه لعنة الله. The first command he heard it from Allah, his response was, why? أنا خير منه خلقتني من نار وخلقته من طين. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Iblis to prostrate to Al-Malaika, the first thing he said, why? I'm better than him. You created me from fire and you created him from clay. How comes that I have to prostrate to him, to Adam? Adam should prostrate to me. Allahu Akbar. I'm sorry, I said something wrong. Allah commanded Iblis to prostrate to Adam. And Allah commanded the angels as well. Then the angels prostrated to Allah and Iblis didn't like that. Why, ya Iblis? Adam from clay, I'm from fire. How comes that I'm gonna prostrate to someone you created him from clay? Yeah, come with me please and try to apply these 3 feelings which we're talking about. The feelings of Al-Kibr. The first thing, dominate. He loves to control. How comes that I'm gonna prostrate for someone? Ya akhi, obey Allah. He is your Lord. Oh, this is with logic and sense. They don't believe in sense. Yeah. Then the second thing, they don't believe in the rights of others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give Adam honor. And this is his right. And Allah, he is the one who created you and him. And he gave Adam this right, this haqq, this honor. And he is ordering you, commanding you to prostrate to him. وبعدين, why fire is better than clay? What is the point here? Actually, with logic, fire is destroying things. Clay, mashallah, you have a lot of crops and a lot of productions. It comes from clay. What is better? Who is better? Why fire is better? Yeah, this is from Iblis' perspective. Again, I'm better than him. I'm better than him. Fire, but water, clay, oil. It doesn't matter with Iblis. The only thing matter for him that I'm better than him. Then I'm gonna use my own logic stuffs. I'm from fire. He said, Iblis alayhi lanatullah. This is the three bad feeling. And the actions which we talk about it, which is harassing, accusing, abusing, using lies, make istifzaz to invoke someone. Allah said it in the Quran. Here is the link between Iblis, the greatest mutakabbir, and the mutakabbirin, the small mutakabbirin in the earth. There is a big link and a strong connection between them. Allah said this in the Quran. Shayateen al-insi wal-jinn yuhi ba'duhum ila ba'din zukhrufa al-qawli ghurura. Ya Iblis alayhi la'natullah is whispering, and his shayateen, shayateen al-jinn with shayateen al-ins. Shayateen al-jinn are whispering to the shayateen al-ins to have this bad feeling, to have whispers, to have harassing, to have istifzaz. Allah said in different ayah, واستفزز يا إبليس واستفزز من استطعت منهم بصوتك وأجلب عليهم بخيلك ورجلك وشاركهم في الأموال والأولاد وعدهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا. This ayah is summarizing my khutbah today. The ayah simply, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling to Iblis, there are people who are gonna follow you. I name them shayateen al-ins. And you, Iblis, and shayateen al-jinn, go ahead and make for them these things. First of all, istafziz. Al-istifzaz, to provoke someone and to urge with someone with whispers, with plans, to let him give up and follow you. This is the accurate meaning of al-istifzaz. Wastafziz, oh Iblis, go ahead. ما استطعت منهم بصوتك, with your whispers. وأجلب عليهم بخيلك ورجلك. Use by your shoulders. Use your strength. Use your full words. Try to impact them. Try to affect them to be like you. Go ahead, Iblis. وأجلب عليهم بخيلك ورجلك. وشاركهم في الأموال والأولاد. Participate with them in their wealth, in their health, in their offsprings, in their sons, in their kids. Go ahead. With their businesses, go ahead. وعدهم, promise them. Then Allah said, وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. He just use faking things. Hypocrisy, lies, tricks. If any متكبر in the earth, he is the best student of Iblis actually. He is applying with people what Iblis has been taught him. That's it. This is the summary. Yeah. Accusation, abusing, lies, hypocrisy, provoking, stifzaz, try to participate with you everything with badness, with evil. This is صفات المتكبرين والعياذ بالله. واستفزز من استطعت منهم بصوتك وأجلب عليهم بخيلك ورجلك وشاركهم في الأموال والأولاد وعدهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا. الله أكبر. What is the meaning of غرور? غرور comes from غر. الغر to trick someone. To fake something. Because you wanted to control him. This is الغرور. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. My dear brothers and sisters, this is the definition of الكبر. In the second khutbah, inshallah, I'm going to quote some ayat from Al-Quran and some ahadith and some أقوال أهل العلم بإذن الله تعالى. بارك الله لي ولكم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Check your heart يا حبيب. Make sure, I'm advising myself first and everyone, sisters, brothers, check your heart. Do you have any kind, any feeling of this bad manner, of this bad characteristic, of this bad feeling? Do you feel that you are better than us? Do you feel that you have a speciality that makes you have a preference than others? Check your heart, ya Habib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran says, على لسان لقمان الحكيم رضي الله عنه وأرضاه,
when he was teaching his son.
Listen, 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 oh my brothers and sisters, how these hukama, wise people and anbiya and prophets, how they were teaching their kids. Listen, he said, Luqman radiallahu anhu arda, he told his son, ya son, oh bunay, wala tusa'ir khaddaka linnas, wala tamshi fil ardi maraha, inna allaha la yuhibbu kulla mukhtalin fakhur. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. The beauty of this ayah, just if you know it and ponder it and bring it in your mind, in your heart, at-tas'ir, to turn your nose up like this. This is at-tas'ir. As-su'r, it's disease, it's camel's disease. Make the camels turn their necks and their mouth up. This is as-su'r. When Allah said, la tus'ir, do not imitate the camels when they have these diseases. That means do not turn your nose up to people. Tus'ir like this. لا تصعر خدك. I said in the beginning of the khutbah, Islam is teaching us how to feel. Now Islam is teaching us how to just appear with your limbs. لا تصعر خدك للناس. الله أكبر. كناية. تشبيه بليغ. It's an amazing example. The Quran always used بلاغة. بلاغة means to give you the information with indirect way. الله أكبر. لا تصعر خدك للناس. Don't walk like this and turn your nose up to people. Do not make this. Allah said, لا تصعر خدك للناس. Then, ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا. المرح, the highest level of happiness when it comes with arrogance. المرح, just one Arabic word has a huge meaning. سبحان الله. One word, مرح. What does it mean of مرح? المرح, it comes when you are so happy with arrogance. الله أكبر. لا تصعر خدك للناس ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا. Don't walk on the earth with this kind of happiness, but with, mixed with arrogance and ego. Do not make this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن الله لا يحب. Allah does not love. Allah does not like. What ya Allah? Who ya Allah? Inna Allah la yuhibbu kulla, everyone, mukhtalin fakhur. Everyone has khuyala. Khuyala means kibr, arrogance. Fakhur, he has arrogance with his wealth and with his families, with his offsprings. Al fakhur wal khuyala. Al khuyala to have general arrogance. This is khuyala. Al-fakhur, the one who has arrogance because of his wealth and his offsprings. Allahu Akbar. Every single word in this ayah, we have to take it and hang it in front of our eyes, my dear brothers and sisters. Every single word. La, do not. Tusa'ir, do not turn your nose up to people. Linnasi. Wala, do not. Tamshi, walk. Fil ardi, on the earth. Maraha, with the highest level of happiness mixed with arrogance. Inna Allah, Allah does not love. Everyone has khuyala, that means arrogance, general arrogance, and fakhur, that means proudness with arrogance because of your wealth and because of your offsprings. Allah la yuhib. Allah does not love. Subhanak. سبحان الله. Another hadith. This is ayah. Surah Luqman. Hadith عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. Collected in Musnad al-Imam Muslim. According to this narration, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من تواضع لله رفعه ومن تكبر على الناس وكره الناس أذله الله سبحانه وتعالى. الله أكبر. Great hadith عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whoever humble to people, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will raise him. Allah will raise his estate سبحانه وتعالى.
You will be raised عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. Your maqam, your state will be raised عند الله. If you are humble to people, if you are humble to people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your state subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever humiliate people and have arrogance with people, وَكَرِهَ النَّاسِ, he doesn't like people and he is so arrogant with them, Allah said أَذَلَّهُ اللَّهِ, أَذَلَّهُ اللَّهِ, وَاللَّهِ Allah will humiliate him. He will be humiliated. This is the hadith. Ya أهل الحديث والسنة, come back to our sunnah. Come back to a hadith of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do not just claim that you are Sunni and you do not follow the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The real hadith, the authentic one. Many people claiming they are Sunni and they are so arrogant with people, with ulama, with imams, with regular friends, with brothers, with relatives. Where is the sunnah? حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, من تواضع لله رفعه الله. When you are humble to people, Allah will raise your state. When you are so arrogant with people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will humiliate you. You will be humiliated, مهان, ذليل. سبحانك يا رب. My dear brothers and sisters, I will end my khutbah with three أقوال from أهل العلم. I quoted one saying from سيدنا الإمام علي رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, وكرم الله وجه علي ورضي الله عن الصحابة جميعا ابتداء بأبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي. علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه وأرضاه said in this great statement, الكبر هو أعظم الذنب. الله أكبر. والغمط, he said الكبر, to have arrogance, this is أعظم الذنب, this is the greatest sin according to علي رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. والغمط, that means you are arrogant with people and you are oppressing people. والغمط يوقف الرزق, it's a stopping provision from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. الله أكبر. الكبر والغمط. الكبر, general arrogance, if you have it, this is the big sin, he said, the biggest one. And الغمط, to be arrogant with people and to oppress them. He said, والغمط يوقف الرزق, it will stop the provision which has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. Maybe you have provision but there is no barakah. The barakah of the provision, Allah will stop it if you have arrogant and are you oppressing our people. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the statement from Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. I need time to have a details with these statements, but because of the time, let us go to the second one, which is a statement comes from Sidna al-Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullahu ta'ala, Abu Hamid al-Ghazali. Abu Hamid al-Ghazali used to say and to write and to teach this great statement about al-kibr radiyallahu anhu arda. He used to say al-kibru yahriqu al-dhanb, sorry, al-kibru yahriqu al-hasanat. Allahu akbar. Arrogance is burning hasanat. Allahu akbar ala al-statement. Al-kibru yahriqu al-hasanat. Arrogance is burning, eating al-hasanat. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. سُبْحَانَكَ يَا رَبِّ. How you know Imam al-Ghazali? He's a knowledgeable person رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. Last statement because of the time, it comes from Imam al-Shafi'i رحمه الله تعالى ورضي الله عنه وأرضاه. Imam al-Shafi'i used to say this great statement, الكبر يحلق الحسنات. الله أكبر. الكبر يحلق الحسنات. الكبر is like shaver and you are shaving the حسنات with it. الغزالي said يحرق, burn. الشافعي said يحلق, shave. Imagine that your حسنات like your hair. Instead to grow it, and no, you're gonna shave the whole thing. Instead you beautify it and grow it and make it nice, looks nice. No, you shave it. You shave your hasanat, ya habibi. You make hasanat then with one sin, kibr. وصدق الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم in this great hadith which I will end with khutbah with عندما قال سبحان الله والله لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر.
The Prophet says according to this narration that nobody enter Jannah if he has a amount like the weight of ant from pride. If you have it in your heart, you won't enter Jannah. Who said this? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to Hadith al-Sahih, which is narrated in al-Bukhari or Muslim.
It's a scary hadith. Scary hadith. لا يدخل الجنة.
What about if he prays years? Make ta'at, donations, عبادات لله سبحانه وتعالى.
Yeah. But he has arrogance in his heart.
سبحانك يا رب. سبحانك يا رب. سبحان الله, there is a statement comes to my mind now. الإمام أبو حنيفة رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. He used to say, الكبر ازدراء مع الله. الله أكبر على الستيتمنت. الكبر, when you have كبر, that means you are taking right from the rights of Allah. He is المتكبر, not you. He is المتكبر. You are stealing and transgressing a one right from the rights of God. Who are you? This is the statement of Abu Hanif. Who are you? You are taking, transgressing a right from the rights of Allah. He is المتكبر. Who are you? Who are we? As a bashar, Allah, He is al-Jabbar, al-Mutakabbir, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, if you find any kind of kibr in your heart, please purify it. Make tawbah lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you know anybody has this kind of kibr, try to avoid him. Try to be away. He is using one right from the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like what Abu Hanifa said radiyallahu anhu wa ardaah. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna wa ma asrarna wa ma a'lanna وما أنت أعلم به منا, أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر, لا إله إلا أنت. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا, اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا. اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين, اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانية ولنبيك بالرسالة وماتوا على ذلك. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم. اللهم أكرمنا بهم في جنة الفردوس مع حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم احفظ شبابنا بحفظك الذي لا يرام, اكلأهم يا ربي بعينك التي لا تنام, رد عنهم كيد الكائدين وحسد الحاسدين وأعين العائنين واعتداء المعتدين وشر من عنده شر يا رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة, إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.